In my last video, I made a track out of just one short, mildly inappropriate sound source, using multiple sound transformations to craft instrumental sounds. I took this opportunity to talk briefly about composing with any sound whatsoever, mentioning electroacoustic music and musique concrète. My track, though, could not be considered to belong in the electroacoustic acousmatic sonic art genre, although made with relevant techniques, for a very important reason. Its musical functions rely heavily on metered rhythm, traditional melodic and harmonic relationships, as well as recognizable instrument identities. As music, it works inside the lattice. Sound recording and the transformative possibilities this invention has brought into existence over the years, in conjunction with the aesthetic and conceptual evolution in the 20th century, has opened our ears and our hearts to all sounds of the world. The recording of a natural soundscape, the symphony of city noise, a bucket of cutlery falling down a staircase, a washing machine working through its cycles. Everyday sequences of real-world sound can have huge potential for musical enjoyment, the noises of the world discovered and appreciated as music. However, found sound, aleatoric noise collages, and the role of the listener as the composer of their own experience will be the subject of another video. At this point, I'm interested in another thought process. Once we have creative access to any sound imaginable, and a large palette of techniques at our disposal for sculpting spectral behaviors, we can make music in the continuum, articulating timbre freely and developing sonic relationships far beyond traditional paradigms for pitch and rhythm. At the same time, it's good to keep in mind that tonal and rhythmical functions as tools of musical expression have been developed over centuries. They are very well understood and deeply felt. Their power is rooted in our auditory perception mechanisms and hold strong after centuries of cultural conditioning. So they are in no way to be undervalued or neglected. They represent very important special cases in the continuum, and treating them as such is of course a matter of style and compositional intention. The rigors of formalized music can be expanded into the sonic continuum with a generalization of ideas such as melody, harmony, or counterpoint. It is about crafting sound streams that relate to one another and interact during the course of their separate development, creating a feel that the overall musical texture is going somewhere. As Trevor Wishart in his book on sonic art from 1996 puts it, we can establish two criteria for our recognition of a contrapuntal structure, an architectural principle which supplies points of reference in the overall progression of the musical material and corresponds to the key structure in tonal counterpoint, a dynamic principle which determines the nature of the motion. In tonal note against note counterpoint, this is related to the ebb and flow of rhythmic coordination and the ebb and flow of harmonic consonance dissonance, both of which arise from the way in which notes in individual parts are placed relative to notes in other parts. So, in the architectural dimension, we will replace the progression from one key to another by the concept of transformation from one timbral or sound morphological area to another. In the dynamic dimension, we will replace the interplay of consonance-dissonance in harmonic progressions by the idea of gestural evolution and interaction between the separate streams. Other sonic dimensions can be added into this interplay, such as the behavior of sound in space, or the recognizability of sound objects sonic landscape as put by Wishart and relating to Dennis Smalley's degrees of surrogacy. Smalley, also building on the work of Pierre Schaeffer, defines spectral typologies and proposes morphological archetypes towards a classification of sound objects and sound object behaviors, towards a detailed language and an intuitive way of thinking about sound that takes into account its complex time-varying nature. We are casually scratching the surface here, and this discourse is a huge subject of contemporary music academia, with numerous writings and compositions exploring the countless creative folds of the sonic continuum. So let's make a piece of music. Just for kicks, I will use a traditionally musical sound, the sound of a chord on guitar, sort of an A minor 11, but it doesn't really matter as I will change it a lot going forward. I want to compose a short study, an electroacoustic miniature in my style, with just this sound in as little time as possible. I will make a quick graphic score so I can think about structure and make some decisions beforehand. I'm starting with one instance of the original sound and proceed presenting a kind of theme that's obviously stemming from the original instance. That theme will be elaborated on with a developing discourse between elements, gradually coming to a nodal point where a new soundscape will be presented. This new environment will host a second discourse, which, developing through a second nodal point and revealing variations of the first part, will lead to a coda. Pauses are a very important element in any composition, although very easy to forget. One could say that the most treasured sound object is silence, with a value that infuses any other sound that comes in its vicinity. This piece is another proof of concept made just for this video in as little time as possible. My goal was to demonstrate some concepts and not to refine my sound. Shortcuts were taken, and the overall quality and originality of the sonic palette of the piece leaves a lot to be desired. Having said that, I'm happy with what I managed to do in a day and some run-of-the-mill processes. Also, I must say that if you know what you're doing or have the right conceptual and technical background to afford to not know what you're doing, you can do something like this in real time, improvising. Here is my piece, I hope you like it. Also, if you like the video, click the like button and subscribe to my channel, as I will be doing more of these videos. Thank you. Thank you for watching.